Well, they are massive, strong, and agile, and yet they still need our protection. And as Dave LeFave tells us, one local man has made it his mission to protect whales in our local waters.
We see it every day, whales interacting with humans in the waters off our coast. Peter Hamilton has made it his mission to protect some of the biggest creatures in our waters.
There's a better chance of J-Pod being up just north of the South Arm there.
Hamilton founded Life Force in 1981. It is a group dedicated to protecting marine mammals. Hamilton monitors boat traffic, promotes land-based whale watching, and researches the behavior and travel patterns of orcas.
Some killer whales, some orcas came up here. Have you seen them today?
Harassing the whales is actually illegal under the Marine Mammal Protection Act. Some simple guidelines to follow: keep your speed below 7 knots when you're within 400 meters, never get closer than 100 meters, and when approaching or departing, always do so from the side, never head on.
The boat harassment would cause stress and interrupt the lifestyle of these orcas. Because it's just like constantly being around cars driving around you and driving at you. It's going to interrupt your lifestyle. It's going to stop you from eating when you want, from playing when you want, socializing when you want.
Hamilton's local marina gives him free moorage, and he says most people are supportive of his work. In the last 10 years, he says Life Force has distributed more than 50,000 guideline books.
Most of the time, they're getting too close, and sometimes like they're just driving right over top of them.
Interestingly, Hamilton supports whale watching as it can help protect the species. His hope is that people will watch from a respectful distance, something that shouldn't be too hard on the open waters. In Vancouver, Dave LeFave, City Pulse.